Imagine a server with lots of PII, personally identifiable information. Imagine passwords stored in plain text, credit card numbers, addresses, and even healthcare-related information. Imagine the administrators deliberately not putting any form of cybersecurity on the server. What is this? A bad dream? No, this is by design. A server like this is called a honeypot. A network of these machines is called a honey net. Decoy systems are deployed on networks designed to lure potential attackers away from critical systems. This also allows security specialists to collect information about attackers' activities. Typically, these honeypots encourage attackers to stay on the system long enough for administrators to document and respond to the attack. It also allows administrators to refine the firewall rules based on observed attacker behaviors. Deception software is the new wave of honeypots. These decoys can be centrally managed, made to work with other security software, and run through virtualization. Intruders can be fooled at many layers, such as network, endpoint, application, and data, with fake browser credentials in decoy workstations, phony files, data sets, and more. An endpoint might be set up to look like it runs a particular version of Windows when it is really a Linux machine. This will deceive malware into attacking vulnerabilities the system doesn't have. A decoy document can be made to look like it contains new product designs or be embedded with a tracking capability that will let the company know when and from where it was opened.